In this video, I'll show you what are the optimal 4+1 stages and also what are the steps within each of these stages to implement ISO 27001 and also how to use a software like Conformio to help you with these stages and steps. Now, it's interesting that this standard doesn't actually give you a clue on what are the implementation steps, because if you went only clause by clause and use this as a main guideline for your implementation, this wouldn't end up well, because the sequence of these clauses in ISO 27001 were not written with the implementation steps in mind. In other words, you need a clear plan which would provide you the way to comply with the standard. Okay, I'll show you now how these phases and steps look like in Conformio. So the first phase is this project preparation. So basically this is where you actually make sure that you do all the steps to start your project in the best way. And I'll come back in a second to explain the details. The second step is risk management. So this is where you make the most important decisions on what are the biggest risks, but even more importantly, which kind of controls, meaning which kind of policies and procedures you will have to implement. And then in the third phase, you actually implement these policies and procedures. And then in the fourth phase, once you've done the implementation, you're preparing for the external audit and you're doing some mandatory steps to end your implementation and make sure that you are fully ready. And then as the fifth phase, and this is not really a phase, this is simply what happens after your certification, then you have to move into this maintenance mode. So this is basically the phase that lasts continuously after you get certified. And this is where you do various steps related to maintenance. Now, going back to the beginning, so the first phase, project preparation. First, there is an introductory video around the implementation process, and then you're setting up how you handle your documents, procedure for document record control. Then you are setting your project plan. So basically, who is the project team, who is the project manager, these kind of things. Then procedure for identification of requirements. So basically how you're recognizing your stakeholders and how you're listing their requirements related to your company. And then you have this register of requirements. This is where you list all of these requirements and stakeholders. ISMS scope document, where you define whether you're going to apply ISO 27000 for your whole company or part of your company. Then you're writing the top level policy, and then you do this first round of information security awareness for your team. So basically all of these steps are considered preparatory because you're still not doing the main steps, as you will see in the phases 2 and 23. Okay, in the phase 2, risk management, you start with writing this methodology. So basically you're setting the rules on how do you do risk assessment and treatment. And then you actually do the risk assessment and treatment by recording the assets and threats and vulnerabilities and controls and all the other things into risk register. And then you move the information about which controls you need into the statement of applicability. And this is where you make final decisions on which controls to implement, but also which kind of documentation you need to cover these controls. And this is where it takes you to the next phase, where you actually start writing security documentation. And here you see various policies and procedures that are available through Conformio for covering various controls. And then when you move on to this fourth phase, you will see that there are some steps like a procedure for non-conformities and corrective actions. So this is where you actually prepare the process for handling the non-conformities corrective actions. Their internal audit procedure. Again, this is where you prepare for doing the internal audit. You're creating this initial training plan for training your employees. You're setting up your security objectives. You're setting up your management review. And then you actually perform the internal audit and you perform this first management review. And these are basically the last steps when you get prepared for the certification. And then at this point, you actually go for the certification itself. Once you pass the certification, then you move on into this maintenance phase. If you wonder whether you can change the sequence of these steps, then of course the answer is yes, because these steps are not defined by the standard. And so you can approach the implementation in your own way. But from our experience working with thousands of clients, we think that these steps are the ones that will enable you to first implement the standards in a quickest way, and second, make sure that you didn't forget about something important. And if you want to implement a couple of steps at the same time, this is also possible. and we see many of Conformio clients actually do so. However, there are some steps that you shouldn't skip or that you shouldn't do in parallel. For example, let's say this register of requirements you should not be doing before you actually complete the procedure for identification of requirements, because if you want to list all of these requirements, first you need to know the rules. You should not write the scope document before you collect all the requirements. For example, some of your clients might require a certain part of your company to be certified. You shouldn't be doing this top-level security policy before the scope document, because when writing this policy, you want to know how big your scope is. And also this information security awareness, you shouldn't be doing this before you complete the top-level policy, because this awareness has to refer to this policy itself. But one of the most important things that you should really be careful about is this statement of applicability. You should not be doing this before you complete a risk register and before you complete a register of requirements, because the two main inputs into statement of applicability are risks and requirements. And when you actually start working with Conformio, if you go directly to the statement of applicability, you will simply see an empty register if you didn't fill out these requirements and risks prior to this. And also these policies and procedures, basically you cannot start writing them before you complete the statement of applicability, because in the statement of applicability you make these decisions on which controls to apply, but also which documents to use to cover these controls. You can't really have these documents before you make the step of statement of applicability. If you wonder why would you have to fill out resources and training and awareness for each of these implementation steps, basically this is because from our experience, these two things are the biggest blockers when implementing the standard. Usually you cannot perform a certain step either because you don't have enough people or money to implement them, or people that actually have to do something do not know how to do it. So when you actually define these things upfront, then it becomes easier for you to implement each of these steps. And you can see this once you open a particular step, so procedure for document record control. When I click it, you see these general details about this step. But when you scroll down, you actually see what kind of awareness you can raise for this particular step, what kind of training you can organize for your employees, and then what kind of resources in terms of technology, human resources, and finance you need. So for example, for technology, you could have a document management system. For human resources, you might have, let's say, office manager for, let's say, 2 hours to write these documents. And for finance, you might have, let's say, $200 per month for DMS, right, for document management system. So this is in general how you fill this out. What's good is that then Conformio summarizes this information and then lists all of these things in one place, for example, for all the resources that are needed or for all the trainings that are needed. So to conclude, when you have this kind of streamlined process, you actually spend much less time implementing the standard, and also you decrease the chance of something going wrong. And ultimately, it enables you to implement the standard even if you're not an expert, and you can do this as a beginner for the first time without any prior experience. So make sure that you have this implementation sequence properly defined to make sure that your implementation project actually succeeds. Hope this was helpful, and to sign up for a free trial of Conformio, click the link in the description below and you'll be able to test out all of these implementation steps and see for yourself how they work. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up. And you can also subscribe to my YouTube channel not to miss any of my new videos. And I publish videos about ISO 27001 every week. Thanks for watching.